This is a very unique spot in Iowa where we can learn lots about our geological history by studying the changes in the layers of this rock. Where could I be in Iowa? Come explore with me. Sometimes the rocks that tell the history of Iowa are in places where people drive by every day without ever recognizing how special they really are. Just like the rocks we're exploring today in Northeast Iowa in a town called Graff, where we can see layers and layers of ancient rocks right on the side of the road. By studying the layers from the bottom all the way up to the top, we can tell so much about Iowa's history. Millions and millions of years ago, this rock was deposited in Iowa. My good friend John lent me one of his favorite geology tools to take a closer look. Some of the layers are made out of shale. They're softer because they're made out of clay and sand. Some of the layers are made out of limestone. They're a whole lot harder. These layers of limestone and shale are evidence that Iowa was once covered in a warm, tropical sea. The alternating layers tell us that the sea sort of came and went, or there were times where it was much deeper and much shallower. The limestone contains even more evidence of Iowa's history. Can you guess what it is? The limestone in Graff, Iowa is so special because it contains fossils. These fossils are actually sea creatures. This fossil is a nautiloid cephalopod. These creatures lived in the warm tropical sea that once covered Iowa. So how does a creature once living and swimming around in the sea become fossilized and part of a rock? Just like all forms of life, sea creatures from long ago died. And when they died, they sank to the bottom of the sea and into sediment, or mud. Eventually, more and more sediment piled on top of them until the creatures were completely buried. Over time, that sediment turned into sedimentary rock. And so did the remains of the creature. They literally turned into rock. The nautiloid cephalopod is just one type of fossil. Do you think there could be other types of fossils in other places in Iowa?
Funding for Find Iowa has been provided by the following supporters.